It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on.
Month episode of Candy Fresh. We are down here in St. Paul at Element Boxing and Fitness. I'm your host, Sanni.
And I'm Miss Brit. On tonight's episode, we have a lot of special guests coming through. First up, we have visual artist Ron Brown, as well as Emmy Award winner PaviElle French.
We also have a young man named Jaga. He is the creator of Hepicat. And we also have the honor of interviewing Dalton Outlaw. He is the owner and operator of Element Boxing and Fitness.
Now, we can't let the show get started without sending some major love to DJ Fundraiser, who's going to be holding down for us on the ones and twos.
Give it up, give it up, give it up, y'all! Yeah.
And of course, we're going to send some love to the Wayman for Christ. We're going to be coming through and doing their thing later on in the show as well. Show some love for them as well.
Give it up to the ladies.
Parker, Parker, he will be snatching wigs on the red carpet out there. Make sure we get some footage
your
of him.
Just snatched, baby.
Okay, no, perfect season for Black History Month. He's also going to be doing some audience interviews with us today. So yeah, give it up for him.
We're gonna go ahead and get started for the evening. So make sure you sit back and relax, because this is
Candy Fresh.
So tonight joining us at Candy Fresh's fifth episode taping is
Heather McElrath.
Nice. So how did you hear about Candy Fresh?
Well, I'm friends with Bianca, PaviElle, and one of the mothers of one of the Wayman steppers.
So what are you most excited about tonight?
This is actually my first time coming to one of the filming, so I'm really excited to see how they put everything together. Really excited to see PaviElle sing live. I love that it is in a gym and that the steppers are going to be stepping in a boxing ring.
Yes.
So excited about that.
So the Wayman boys are performing tonight. Tell me about them and how do you have a connection with them and what we can expect.
My lovely friend Shauna here, who will come in after me, one of her, two of her sons are in the Wayman Steppers. And I just love that they're doing a Black History Month focus and that these young men are really doing great things in the community with stepping. And is it Scott? Scott, the director that's put together the routines, has done a great job with these young men.
That's amazing. I don't know what stepping is, but I do know how to do the dab. Isn't it like
the dab.
That's all I know how to do. That's a step move, right?
That's
that is. Well, I'm really excited to see the Wayman boys perform tonight. Hi.
Hey.
So is this your first time coming to Candy Fresh?
It is my first time.
And it won't be your last time, correct?
Oh, no.
No. We keep it fresh, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So far, what is your favorite part of Candy Fresh so far? Just getting here.
A few connections. One, is one of the producers. I actually went to the same college that she went to, so it's a joy to see her doing her thing.
And what producer is that?
That would be Bianca Rhodes.
Bianca Rhodes, do you know she just won an Emmy, correct?
Yes, yeah, so that's proud amazing. Of her. Hometown talent doing it.
Yes, I love it, I love it. So I also hear that you're friends with the Wayman boys.
That's right, I have two sons who are participating in the Wayman Steppers too.
Nice, and how long does that take to get the art of stepping down?
It takes time. It takes time, discipline, passion, and consistency.
Candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on.
Welcome back. You are watching Candy Fresh. I'm your host, Sanni, and sitting with me today, or standing, boxing? No? Not yet? No?
Not yet.
Okay, all right. In a few seconds? All right. This is Dalton Outlaw. You are the owner, operator, creator,
Founder.
All the above of Element Boxing and Fitness. First of all, thank you for having us.
No problem. I appreciate you guys being here.
All right, thank you. So it's Black History Month. So let us know a little bit about how Element got started and how you came to this, because I heard several people in the audience going, wow, they haven't been over here in a minute and really experienced the growth. And then explain how you are making Black History here in the Twin Cities.
Yeah, most definitely. I'll start with my story with the boxing. I started boxing when I was 8 years old. You know, after I boxed for, you know, many years, I've been in national tournaments and, I explored the world of boxing and competed. I went to college as well. So after I graduated from college, there was a low supply of boxing gyms. So I took it upon myself to, open up a gym for the local community that really needs boxing, especially the African-American community. Yeah. So I didn't start out in this big gym that everybody sees today. I started out in the basement gym. Not even 1,000 square feet. Right here is 8,000 square feet.
Wow.
So we didn't start right here. We started small, and we continue to grow and, get to where we are now. And, I'm blessed to stand here today and be in this big gym.
Okay. All right. So, They fight?
Get it.
So are these some of the community members? These are your fighters? Like, give me some details on your fights.
Yeah, these are a couple of our young amateur fighters, up-and-coming fighters. One of them actually was one of my trainers. He trains some of the kids and he trains the adults, the personal training and boxing training. So they both excelled in the amateur rankings. Yaya and the Black was actually ranked in the novice division. He's ranked number one. And Jorge is welcome. And they come to the gym every single day, work hard, and put in the hard work, dedication to get the job done.
Do they train some of your?
And they do train. They train some of our clients that come here. So they came under my belt. I brought them up. I taught them boxing. And now that's one of Yaya is actually, one of our trainers. So he trains clients and stuff like that.
Tell me about the boxing scene here in the Twin Cities. I know somebody that was telling me it's kind of quiet. So how did you get to this point with the boxing scene that seems kind of quiet?
Yeah. No. It definitely is quiet. But, there's still a demand for it, and there's still, the love for boxing. People are always going to love boxing. It's been around for hundreds of years. My job in that is to continue to run my facility and, develop it and make sure it's nice and clean. There's a lot of gyms that you're going to, dusty, dirty, and they're not taking care of it. What happens is the people who have founded it and own it and stuff like that aren't putting in extra dedication and time and effort and funds to be able to, run and operate those gyms.
Right.
I personally put my funds into the gym. I personally put my blood, sweat, and tears into this gym and allow it to be open to the community for people to come in here and receive the same benefits that I've received in my growing years as a kid going through boxing.
You can definitely tell. You can definitely tell. So what is something sweet that you are looking to personally as a, are you still boxing?
Yeah, I still box from time to time. I get in here and spar with my guys to help them get ready, but as a professional, I've been 2-0 as a professional boxer. I put that kind of on a hold, for my professional boxing career, because it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of effort. But when that pulls me away from my business, then it takes away from the community and what I'm really trying to build.
Right. So what are you looking forward to, business-wise, personal, boxing-wise? Yeah. Something sweet you looking forward to?
Yeah, most definitely. It's something I always continue to talk about. The movement is bigger than boxing, The movement is huge. Like you said, you guys don't know much about boxing. Well, in the next few years, with the movements that we're making, people are going to start hearing more about boxing. It's going to start getting out there. And that's why it's so important for this group to be here today and those guys to be in there stepping, to be inside of this gym and using the gym for what it really should be used for, as a community establishment, for everybody. keep reiterating the community aspect. This is a boxing gym. We're like I said, bigger than boxing. We have a ballet dance. A lot of you guys seen that. Those are the guys that are affiliated with us. Next door, Taekwondo. All these groups are affiliated with us. So we have all these collaborations going on within this space.
Is it? Are you focused more on health or community? Like, what's your focus?
Yeah. Health in the community. You got it right there.
I do that sometimes. So where can we follow you? Where can we find you, social media wise? I mean, clearly we can find you. You right in Twin Cities, so.
Yeah, Element Boxing and Fitness on Facebook, www.elementboxingandfitness.com. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, Element Boxing, you know, and we're there. And my personal is Dalton Outlaw. You guys know my name now, so look me up, you know.
Well, thank you, Dalton.
You're very welcome.
Y'all give it up for Dalton Outlaw. Right now we're gonna throw it over to Parker Parker. We're gonna get some audience interviews. Keep watching Candy Fresh.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight at the Candy Fresh Filming.
No,
what's your name?
Angel Lee. Angel?
Yep. I love it. I love it. Angel Lee, that's fun. So tell me about yourself. I love this fun, fresh outfit.
Oh, thank you.
All
I had
black.
To get Candy Fresh for you guys today. I'm here just in support of Bianca and the whole Candy Fresh staff. I also am a part of SPNN, so I'm a freelance videographer and photographer. I'm also flirting with management right now, so I'm here in support of DJ Mickey Breeze, the 14-year-old DJ.
I love it.
And I'm just here to enjoy the scene and have a good time.
Nice. Are you a fashion stylist too?
No, but I need you in my life because I swear I wear this with everything.
No, but it looks good, and you know your body type, and you know how to dress it.
Yes.
I love it. I love it. Well,
I have an A-line. Whatever that means.
I love it. Well, tonight we have PaviElle French performing, and then we also have the Wayman boys performing tonight as well. Yes, it's gonna
be. Are they the steppers?
Yes, they're steppers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So they be dabbing.
Yeah. I want to see it.
So I'm really excited for tonight. Tonight's gonna be really fun and fresh. And then we also have Sweets by Extravagant Events and Sweets, and they're so good. So
good.
It's a chicken and waffle cupcake. Can you believe that?
I'm working on it. But I'm gonna have a little bit.
A little bit. Yeah, they're so good. They're so good. So tonight's definitely gonna be really fresh. Candy Fresh. Well, thank you guys for joining us tonight at Candy Fresh. Can I have you guys introduce yourself?
Yes, my name is Shauna Moses.
Tamika McDavid.
And Jamie Spears.
Nice. So what is your connection with this event tonight?
We all have sons and the Wayman Steppers.
Nice. All right. So your sons all step? Great. So tell me how they got into stepping.
It's a stepping ministry through Wayman AME Church, and it's just affiliated through Sean Burns, who's a teacher and advocate at Mass 3 Harvest Network programs of schools, and we all just got recruited some way, somehow.
Yep.
So do you feel like this, is this an after-school kind of a thing, or after-school, or is it only on Sundays? Like, when do they practice?
That's a question. They practice after school. Usually in the evening, you know, after everybody's home from school on Mondays, is the younger boys practice on Mondays. So
and the older boys practice Wednesday evening.
Yep.
Do you feel like them having this little side hobby helps them be more productive and goals and other things in their lives?
Absolutely.
Nice. Burns off extra energy.
Burns off extra energy. So do you guys know how to step now that you guys are all mothers of steppers?
Oh, yeah.
Show me some of the steps.
Oh, right now?
Yeah,
right now. Are you ready?
I want to see it. I want to see
some of my own.
I want to see it. Yes.
Why did I say that?
Right? Let's see. All right. Oh, get it.
Look at
him. Yeah, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Well, we can definitely see where your son get his moves from. You know, you have it. You guys know how to step too?
Exactly. We're just
going to
let you see the boys.
Right. You're going to see the boys perform. Great. Well, is this you guys' first time to the show?
Yes.
Well, you guys are in for a great surprise. It's going to be fun and fresh. We have the live DJ. We have the live interviews. So you guys are going to have fun. It was so nice for you guys to join me on the red carpet.
Thank
yeah.
You.
Nice
Thank
to meet you guys. Thank you for joining us tonight at our fifth taping of Candy Fresh. You actually DJ'd at one of the Candy Fresh tapings, correct?
I think it was the second episode, or third.
Episode three. Nice. No problem. So, what are you expecting tonight for the show?
In Element Boxing, I actually know somebody who does work or partially own this. I'm expecting a good turnout of a bunch of Minnesota businessmen or businesswomen to come out and participate in an all-over fun night.
Nice. Well, you're not DJing tonight. Do you know the DJ that is?
Yeah, DJ Fundraiser, or Jay Espinoza. Me and him are friends, actually.
candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy fresh, come show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city.
It was a ministry for at Wayman Church for young men to get them engaged into church because, you know, women are always involved in the church. And we're just trying to reach our young men and get them involved in the church and help them grow spiritually. So the ministry started at Wayman Amy. It was a ministry just for those young men who attended Wayman Amy Church. But since 2011, it became an outreach ministry because we realized that there are other young men in the Twin Cities area who could benefit from being in such a ministry, such as this. So we opened our doors, and now it's become an outreach ministry for young African-American men age 7 to 18 years old.
Okay, and you brought some of your young men here tonight.
Yes, I actually brought two groups.
Okay.
We are the Wayman Boys of Christ Ministry right now is ministering by 35 young men aging from 7 as the youngest, and I think the oldest is actually 15 years old. So we have the pre-steppers that are going to perform, and then we also have our older steppers who are on the competitive traveling team as well.
So how long does it take you to prepare for something like this where you're showcasing in front of the public?
It takes a while. It takes a while. We actually practice Mondays and Wednesdays, so for about an hour and a half. When we're preparing for shows such as this, you know, we add in additional rehearsals. So, but the young men have been working really, really hard. Very proud of them. I love them, and we're stepping for Christ.
All right, we're gonna do it. Well, go ahead and introduce your boys right now.
Okay.
And, let's get into it.
All right, the best step team in the world. This is God's favorite step team.
Yeah.
I give you the Wayman Boys, Steppers for Christ.
Step is for Christ, we are precise, and God is the head of my life.
here that you're the man responsible for all these steppers tonight?
Yes, sir. Great. Yes, sir.
So
yes,
tell
sir.
Me about your organization and what you do.
Okay. So we're the Wayman Boys Steppers for Christ. Our ministry was founded at Wayman AME Church in 2009. It was a ministry to engage young men to get into church. In 2011, it became an outreach ministry for young African-American men across the Twin Cities, age 7 to 18.
Mm-hmm. So what is the routine rehearsal like for these kids, like the younger ones and the older ones? How do you make it so that they can get the literacy for this program to get the steps down?
You know, I create a lesson plan of steps, if you know, believe it or not. I break down the steps. I put them into small groups so that they can learn from each other. Then it's like, oh, sorry. So put them in small groups. They learn it from each other that way. Then I bring them back for whole group, and voila. It's like putting together a puzzle. You know what
nice.
I mean?
So yeah. How did you learn how to step?
You know, I learned how to step in high school. My step coach was an alpha. And then I went on to college, and then I went on to be a man of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, and then became a stepmaster for my fraternity. And voila, here we are.
Well, you're doing a great job.
Thank you.
So keep it going.
Thank you.
Amazing steppers. Remind everyone what your step house name is.
The Wayman Boys Steppers for Christ.
Thank you so much. Well, we're here tonight at Candy Fresh, and the Wayman Boys just did an amazing performance. Tell me your name.
Xavier.
Trevia.
Tylen.
Jaden.
How hard is it to learn what you guys just did tonight? Is it fun
it
for you?
It takes lots of practice.
Lots of work. You guys are doing it for Christ, I heard. Yeah. I love it. So show me one of your favorite moves. Show out, boy. Show out. Oh, I love it. And so who's your teacher?
Mr. Burns.
Nice. I love it. So how many hours do you guys think you put in on this rehearsal for this performance tonight?
A lot.
4 hours.
Over 30 minutes? An hour and 30
Four
minutes?
Hours.
Well, that's impressive for an
Four
hour and 30
hours.
Minutes. 4 hours?
Like every practice.
4 days.
4 days? Y'all were all at different rehearsals, right?
We practiced 3 days straight.
3 days straight? Well, you guys did an amazing job tonight.
It's that Candy Fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy Fresh.
What's up, y'all? We're back right here on Candy Fresh, and with me, I have a classic man, if I've ever seen one in my life, visual artist, Mr. Ron Brown. Welcome to Candy Fresh.
Thank you. How are you doing tonight?
I'm wonderful, wonderful. Thank you for being here. So let's go ahead and get on into it and tell us what is it that you do and why?
I am a visual artist. I sculpt, paint. I do illustrations. I have my own version of art, which I call, well, not so much my own version, but my style is Afrofuturism. So I kind of dig a little bit outside of the normal dysphoria that you see as far as black art in America is today. I try to push the envelope as far as seeing us in the future, so I don't do a lot of folk art as far as what you would like to see. I do a little bit of stuff that's risque. So.
Okay, and tell us why Afrofuturism and why that's so important.
I believe from an early age, I've honestly never seen us in the future. And so being a sci-fi nerd, being a comic book geek, you usually don't see black representation in those forms. And so I've always wanted to say that, you know, if I can make a niche in this world, I would probably add my niche as far as doing Afrofuturism and making black comics, black illustrations for black people. So.
Okay. Well, tell us about the elements of your art that are inspired by maybe some of the past and present moments of black history.
Usually I don't do political art, but I've been doing a lot of political art because of the situations that we've been facing as people of color, post Barack Obama, you know, racism. A lot of my influences are hip-hop culture, though. You know, they're influenced from, you know, things that I was influenced from anime to comic books, like I said before. A lot of stuff is family, a lot of rooted in our community. I do a lot of community outreach. So just, you know, a reflection of the things that I see is kind of what comes out of my artwork.
What would you say is the role for Black artists, especially in this era when we're seeing such an increase in police brutality and just really going through a lot as people of color in this time? What do you see as the role for Black artists?
Well, I mean, for everybody, art is subjective. Every artist, even if you're Black, you're not obligated to stand up and say that this is how I feel publicly about certain situations. But shame on you, and how dare you not say some things like that when it reflects who you are as a person in this country. So, you know, I use it as a platform to say, you know, F the establishment, I'm you know, F your couch. I'm really pro, really, like, you know, like, I don't care how you feel, and it's unapologetic, you know. I guess what they'll call that is the Cam Newton effect. So I've been on the Cam Newton effect for a long time, and I try to raise my kids on the same, you know, with the same attitude that, you know, we're not asking for handouts, we're not asking for acceptance. It's we're just demanding that you recognize me for who I really am, and that's, you know, God, you know.
Say that. Yes, we can clap for that. We can make some noise for that. Now, speaking of unapologetic Blackness, and since we are here at Element Gym, I want to bring in a quote from Muhammad Ali, who says, "Service to others is the rent that you pay for your room here on earth." So tell us, how is it that you pay your rent? Obviously through art, but what type of service do you provide?
Well, outside of being a professional artist, I work with Hennepin County, and I'm a community health worker. I work in family planning, so I'm actually the safe sex educator for North Minneapolis. I'm also the facilitator for the Father Project. I am also Harrison High School's safe sex educator, as well as the outreach worker for PYC, the Neighborhood Hub, some other stuff. You know, regular people. So it's like I do that. Yeah. I host my own. So every Thursday, like I said, I work in our family planning department at North Point Health and Wellness, which used to be Pilot City, and I host my, I have my own Male Access Now clinic for men to come get themselves checked out for free every Thursday.
Nice. Yeah, we can clap for that. We can make some noise for that. So tell us, with you doing this work within the community, your art is very unapologetic, and it showcases a lot of women's bodies, and also you doing the work, just doing sex education. What are some of the things that you've noticed as far as like stigmas or just like information that's not commonly shared when it comes to our bodies or our sexual health, specifically within the Black community?
I kind of get it both ways. I get women who appreciate me seeing them for who they are, and then I get women who are being brainwashed into believing that their bodies are not beautiful. Mm. Their features are not beautiful. So I try to push the envelope, especially with that, when you see my artwork. I try to keep it kid-friendly tonight, but if you look at some more other things that I create in the future, you'll notice that I really want to push the thought process that God is a woman. Mm.
Amen. Won't he do it? Won't she do it? Keep going.
And so just the fact that God is a woman and we should worship her, I think that's our number one natural resource as Black men to keep us going is our women. And so I kind of got this Afrofuturistic comic book that kind of deals with that. It's hard to explain right here on the spot, but it gets deep. And I hope that, you know, a lot of people embrace it, or not even so much as embrace it, but educate your child with it. Use it as a tool. You know, I have four kids, and I love creating with my kids, and they've inspired me to make, you know, cool work. So
there it is. All right. Well, tell us, where can people go to see more of your work?
You can follow me on Instagram at @AfroAnimeIllustrator_RonBrown. You can also see videos of my work on YouTube at @HipHopIllustratorRonBrown.
There it is. All right. Well, Hip Hop Illustrator on YouTube or Afro Anime Illustrator _ Ron Brown on Instagram. And he also has many of his paintings for sale. So make sure you support Black art and support being unapologetic in your Blackness and truly loving yourself, which is what we're all about here on Candy Fresh. We're going to go ahead and throw it back to Parker Parker, who's going to be doing some more interviews and showcasing that unapologetic Black love and beauty. Make sure you stay tuned. This is Candy Fresh.
Tonight at Candy Fresh, fifth taping. You guys did an amazing job. Tell us about what's your name?
My name's Lade.
Isaiah.
Makai.
Ramaj.
Trayshawn.
Nice. So how did you guys get into stepping?
Well, Wayman boys came to step at my church, and my mom thought it would be a good thing for me, so we tried, and I liked it, so I'm going to keep doing it.
Keep doing it. Nice.
In third grade, Mr. Sean Burns was my teacher, and then so he told me that he was a stepper team. What is it called? A step teacher, and then my mom just signed me up.
When I was younger, they performed at my school, and I liked it, and ever since then, like, I love doing it, so I'm going to stay and keep doing it.
I was in fifth grade when I started step. My mom, she asked me, because I like to sing and dance, so she asked if I wanted to do step, and then she said some people that I knew that was in step, so it was something new to try, and that's why I joined.
I found out about from my aunt and uncle are friends with Mr. Burns, so I learned it from it that way, and I just like performing, so I tried it, something new.
Nice. Well, where do you guys see yourselves going with this? Are you guys gonna go to college and do the stepping?
Yes.
Nice,
yes,
nice. So now in school, what grades are you guys in?
Third.
Fourth. Fourth. So you guys are in elementary school still, and you guys are in junior high, high school. High school? Okay, so how do students react to you guys being steppers? Is it a cool thing?
Yeah, they think, how hard is it? They think, like, how long does it take us to practice just one?
It's just one, nice, nice. Well, it was so nice meeting you guys. And where can people find out about your stepping?
Oh, Sean Burns of Wayman AME Church, yeah.
Okay.
Over north.
Nice, nice. All right, well, so nice meeting you guys. You guys did a great job, and we hope to see more from you guys.
Candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy fresh.
Hold up for the music. Welcome back to Candy Fresh. I'm your host, Sanni, and with me today I have Jaga, the creator of Hepicat. I said that right?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, so I'm just gonna let you go ahead and take it. Explain to us what all of that is, because I know a little bit after doing some Inspector Gadget on Facebook. So go ahead and school us on what Hepicat is.
Okay, so Hepicat is a fashion company for people of Black roots, and what is important about what I'm doing is I'm creating a language for people of African descent who survived the Middle Passage, so you, me, everybody else that's here in Candy Fresh. And the language expresses our story, our roots, our way of seeing the world, our philosophy. And so kind of building off of what Brother Ron Brown was saying earlier, I'm also an Afrofuturist, so I'm thinking about where our folk are gonna be moving forward, but I'm more focused on what are some of the things we need now?
Okay.
So we need a language.
Okay.
Or rather, we got a language, Ebonics, but we don't have a writing system for it.
Right.
So what I'm doing is I'm making the hieroglyphics for Ebonics.
Okay.
And that's what you see on my shirts.
Okay.
And that's what you see right here on the sweatshirts.
Okay.
Yeah, so I can tell you more about it.
That's, first of all, that's bold. Like, I'm just gonna go ahead and create a language. Just up front. I'm just got, so people are sorry out there. I mean, for real, like, you know, the Queens, they got their own slang, and, you know, we grown, so, but isn't that really bold? How did that, tell me where that started. That's bold.
Because I'm Black.
Well, all right, then, clap it up for that. We are bold people.
I just changed my perspective. We already have a language. And everybody that's here with us right now, we come from hundreds of different groups of people, and we all merged into one group. So we brought little fragments and traces of our languages from the continent here. And all I'm doing is putting a symbol to it. So we already made the language. I'm just giving it a face.
Okay, I mean, where are you at with it right now? Is it catching on? Is the babies doing it? Like,
so I actually made, like, I made this specific shirt I made so that you could teach a child or you could teach a friend about Black history.
Mm-hmm.
or black heritage, I should say, because heritage is living. History is what we remember, because it's dead. But we live heritage, we live memory, right? So it's like if you teach somebody what these symbols are, this is the story of black America. Wow. We fell asleep for a long time in the bottom of a boat, right? Then we came here, worked through that drowsiness. But then one day we woke up. So that's the eye opening. We woke up to our potential to change the world, to change our conditions, to have an impact on the fate of the planet, so to speak. And we woke up to our power. So then in this second symbol here, we found a teacher, mainly ourselves, our mothers, our fathers, our ancestors. And that experience helped us to hone all of the gifts that we have, all of our talents, and helped us to figure out how to use them. And then finally, we became warriors. And so we took all of our light and we let it spread around the world. And that's where we are now. That's exactly where we are now. Like, as grim as times may seem right now, if you look at our story and you live our story, then you already know, like, we're a force. We're a force in the world and a force to be reckoned with. And so I wanted to make clothing that honored that legacy and represents that. Yeah, girl.
You go, boy.
Okay, everything you just dropped on me was super heavy, so I'm trying to. A teacher told me once it's hard to take in everything and process everything. So, first of all, where can we find you? Where can we find this art? And I'm just thrown back. I'm still at you making your own language for us. I'm still there. So, where can we find you? Your stuff.
Yeah. So you can find us on Facebook right now. On Facebook, We Hepicat, and you can find me on Instagram, We Hepicat. And I provide services as a stylist. I'm designing menswear now. I have my first suit designed, so if anybody wants to rock the first prototype, please holla at me.
Can I have something cute for the next episode? Can't I like pink, now put that in.
I mean, I can get some pink for you. I got purple for you right now.
Okay, but you know where I'm at. Okay, cool. I know I'm not supposed to end it. I got one last question. So, with everything that's going on, and I like how you said, no matter how grim it's looking, we still a force to be reckoned with. Yeah. What are you doing to fight all the negativity? You know the stuff's been going on in Twin Cities. You know the stuff's been going on all over the country. How are you implementing this? What's your action? Because it's I know you're just not on Facebook. I know you just how are you fighting what you see that's happening? Does that make sense?
Yeah. I mean, I'm a researcher, I'm a scholar, I'm an inventor. So I take different little roots from black culture and I find ways to bring them into practice. So I guess you could say I'm a social practice artist. So like one of the things I'm doing right now is working with a really, really fly crew of brilliant, brilliant artists called the Million Artists Movement. And what we are is essentially the black arts movement for the Black Lives Matter movement.
Okay.
And so we're creating spaces where people can learn about the language, but like learn about how to change society through art.
Okay.
Because art powers change and people power change. Okay. So that's what we teach people how to do. That's one of the spots where I'm engaged with the community at, with the whole struggle at. And I mean, it's clothing, it's armor. So it's like when you're walking around the street, When you have my clothing on you, it's your heritage that is protecting you from how crazy this world is.
Right.
But it's also letting you know that we don't change it real quick.
We got stuff to look forward to.
Yeah. We are what we look forward to.
I like that. Yeah. I like that. That's positive, man. We're about to talk about this interview. Thank you so much for coming out. Give it up for Jaga. That's all I can say. This is Candy Fresh.
right. Well, thank you guys for joining us tonight at the fifth filming for Candy Fresh. Do you guys know the Wayman boys?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Very much so. Both our sons. We have sons that are Wayman boys steppers.
Yep, nice. I have two boys that
so
are
So do you guys step as well?
Well, we're a part of fraternities.
Yep.
Okay, you know, he's a part of that other fraternity.
The
and
greatest
I'm like
fraternity
the
on the face of the earth.
That's what he calls it. One. Okay, he calls it, but the best one. Okay, okay, yeah.
We're both retired.
That's right, yeah, retired, exactly. Right. So I'm a member of Kappa Alpha Psi.
Bust a step right now.
No, I'm not going to do that right now. The knees is gone.
The knees are gone. I see it. Well, we also have extravagant events and sweet treats, hosting the event, sponsoring the event tonight as well, with amazing pastries, as such as this. This is a chicken and waffle cupcake?
Chicken and waffle cupcake,
yes.
Man. Look at that.
You guys want to try it?
Yeah, I do want to try it.
Taste it for me.
I do
taste it for
try
me.
This, man. Okay.
Taste
oh,
it for
my
me.
Goodness, man.
Ooh, yeah. It's a messy one, too. Mm. Is it good?
Man, it's good, man. That's good. Oh, man. Got like the oh, this is good. This is good. This is good. This is good.
Sticky. Yeah. Get it, boy.
With me, I have an Emmy Award winner right here, singer, songwriter, actress, power woman, superwoman, all around just woman of excellence, Miss PaviElle French. Welcome to Candy Fresh. Now tell us, what is it that you do? I know it's many things, but also tell us why.
I am an interdisciplinary artist. I'm a performance artist, vocalist. I dance a little bit on the side.
Okay.
I'm a writer. I wrote a couple plays, and I just do a little bit of everything. I grew up here in Rondo, and I grew up at the Number Theater, so I was one of those kids that was just kind of raised up, and this is what you're going to do because this is who you're around. So my brother was an artist, and he is an artist, and he was there and took me in, so it's kind of ended up where I'm at right now.
Okay. And who are some of the people that have inspired you to do what you do?
Oh, gosh. My brother Ahanti Young, my mother Zula Young, Jim Craven, Abdul El Razak, goodness gracious, on the spot. Regina Marie Williams, Austin Van, I think there was just everybody kind of came together and helped me out. Thomas Cedar Petras, like everybody, anybody who's anybody around here, I grew up under them.
You mentioned being from the Rondo community, and I'm a Rondo baby as well, and I know you actually did a theatrical performance specifically about Rondo. So tell us a little bit about the history of Rondo, how it's impacted you, and then about your play specifically.
Rondo was an all-black neighborhood back in my mom's day. She was born in the mid-50s, and like maybe when she was 10 or so, they interrupted the neighborhood with I-94, east and west. And literally, this was a black neighborhood that was flourishing.
Right.
I mean, thriving, beyond thriving, like it was super crazy. And it was from at least Summit on down, you know, to Pierce Butler at least. You know what I mean? Like we had everything. We had stores, we had everything that we wanted, and they came through, they took houses, they didn't care, they took it from people. And they always kind of just left a
empty void, because then it split our neighborhood. It became Cornbread Alley, Oatmeal Hill, you know, like all the stories and stuff like that split. Everybody, you know, don't go across the bridge, you know, mess with people across the bridge, that kind of stuff. I mean, it's just, it's very sad for me to see. And so I try to keep my memories and I try to keep all these things, because I was such a precocious kid and I was in everybody's business, you know? So like, you know, hanging out with the old heads. And so I have all these stories of hanging with all these old heads and people that people didn't want to really mess with. I was always into people like that. So I wanted to be able to share these stories and share the things that people taught me about my blackness and use my complete artistic platform to represent my blackness however I see fit, because that's my protest.
Yes. This presentation is great.
It's just crazy to me how people can do things to a community and then say it's our fault. The things that you have done to us is our fault. Mm-hmm. And that's nuts. It's like, no, we need to repatriate our neighborhood. I'm all about that. We should be able to repatriate and have sovereign land and take over Rondo and all the black folks move into the houses that they grew up in and things like that. I just think that should be real. We should be able to have that have community.
Yes.
Yeah, we should repatriate. That's real. We should repatriate and take ourselves.
Super important, especially that you are not things that have happened to you, and it is not your burden or your responsibility to carry the things that other people have projected onto you.
Yes.
I love that. So in the spirit of excellence, and that definitely being a focal point of excellence, tell us about this Emmy that you just won, and where is that? Because I want to hold it. but tell us how you recently won an Emmy, what did you win it for, and tell us about that project.
I won an Emmy for a documentary that TBT Lower Town Line did on my life. They just kind of wanted to, they just thought I was pretty interesting.
I think so too. Yeah.
I'm just me, you know. I look at me like, I get to work a job every day. I, you know, I'm from the hood. Folks know who I am, and I'm just, you know, I'm incognito Negro all the time. So you see me when you see me, you know. So and for me, it was like, what are you talking about? You want to follow me and take me places and talk to me and stuff like that. And, you know, they were just really interested in my story about my parents passing and me carrying on their lineage on stage and talking about my parents all the time and stuff. And it won an Emmy. And I just was like, I still don't know what to do with that. I put it in, it's gold. So that thing went in the closet in lockup. Like, I don't take it nowhere. Like, I showed a couple people the day I got it, and then I put that thing up, because, you know, it's old school. I get that from my grandma. You put that up on the shelf. You put that in the little break front. And don't even take that out. Don't touch that, okay? So I put it up, but it's just, it's amazing to me. I still trying to process that they gave me the highest pinnacle for my art at the beginning of my career.
Wow.
And I'm just like, okay, what's next?
Yeah. Well, tell us, what is next for you?
I'm gigging around and doing shows and stuff like that. I will be doing, I'll be playing with Minneapolis March 19th, so I'm really excited. I'll be at the Amsterdam downtown, so I'm like very happy that there'll be some stuff going on downtown St. Paul. So y'all check that out. I'm online and doing all that kind of stuff, but my main thing right now is just trying to write more and do more performance art, because I'm just really bit by that bug. Ever since I did that play, I did another show last year called Bulgarian Fortitude, and now I'm working on something else, because I really like being able to have 45 minutes on stage to tell people how I feel, and they can't tell me nothing. They can't tell me to get away. They can't walk. They can't take me out of there. No, y'all just have to grin and bear it and take this, and then come tell me you love me after that.
That's right. You're going to get this blackness. That's what PaviElle said. You're going to get this blackness. Yes. Now tell us, where can people get all this fabulous blackness on social media? Where can they find you?
My CD is paviel.bandcamp.com, so you can go get the CD on there. It's all, you know, tracks or whatever. I'm on Facebook. It's PaviElle. You can also friend my PaviElle French page. I'm on Instagram as PaviElle, PaviElle Music. And then on Twitter, I'm Revolt and Uprise. Mm-hmm. And it's R3, V-O-L-T, and Uprise. So find me. I'm not hard to find. I'm only PaviElle. I guess there's another PaviElle. Somebody told me somebody named the kid. Because my mama had told her my name, and so there's another kid around here named PaviElle somewhere. But I'm the only one that's a singer here, so y'all can find it.
There it is. We want to thank you for doing everything that you do for yourself, our community, and for advancing the culture forward. We super respect you, honor you, and congratulations again on your Emmy. So, should make some noise for PaviElle, please.
So, is this your first time here at Candy Fresh?
Yes, it is, and I am enjoying the show and the young talent. Sharnaya Caldwell.
Great. So, what do you do, Ms. Sharnaya?
Well, I'm an advocate for my child, and I also help facilitate and coach with Think Small and Ansonetta Caldwell, and we do a parent empowerment leadership workshop for parents and community members with children in school. So basically our parent empowerment group, we teach a few different modules on school readiness, public policy, just engaging parents in the importance of advocating for their children and connecting them with their legislators and that whole process in getting rights for our child and health benefits, and we have trainings a few times a year, and we actually pay parents to come and attend this program with a stipend. We also provide a meal, and we just get the parents ready to help engage in the children's activities as far as being holistically ready to engage in the learning process.
Wow. Well, it seems like you keep yourself busy. So where can people find out more about this?
Well, you can contact Ansonetta Caldwell at 612-600-9288.
Okay. And do you have a website as well?
Yes, we do. It's cansonetta, that's C-A-N-C-I-N-E-T-T-A @gmail.com.
Thank you all. So nice meeting you. And thank you for coming out and supporting Candy Fresh.
Thank you.
We came to step.
All right, well, we're here tonight at Candy Fresh, and who is this vibrant, fresh woman in front of me?
Good evening, I'm Miss Lenora.
Miss Lenora?
Yes.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So tell me about yourself.
I'm a Minneapolis native, somewhat. I am currently in the process of starting a line dance class in Minneapolis. one site in North Minneapolis at Falwell Park, and then the other one in South Minneapolis at Sabathian Community Center.
Great. Wow, so you do line dancing.
Soul line dancing.
What is soul line dancing? What is soul line dancing for those viewers that don't know what that is?
It's non-country.
Non-country. I love it. I love it. I love it. So not Minnesota?
No.
Gotcha. For a native Minnesota like yourself.
It's for everybody.
It's for everyone. Okay. Yeah. Okay, cool. So what can someone expect when they take one of your classes?
I'd say be energized, pumped up, and just energized? Feel good. Yes.
How much?
It's a dance, but it's an exercise.
Is this energized?
Yes.
No? No? Okay. Well, I'm going to take one of your classes. So when is your first class?
The first week in May.
Oh,
I'm sorry. That's the first week. I'm sorry. The first week in March.
First week in March? Okay. Yes. Well, I have time for that. So I'm going to have to come and do one of those line dancing classes.
Yes, please.
Gotcha. So where can someone book this class at?
You can call me at, reach me at Lenora, 612-298-7359, 612-298-7359. Or my email is nzingalive@hotmail.com, nzingalive@hotmail.com.
Great. Well, I look forward to your line dancing class, and I'm pretty sure our viewers do as well. So it's so
nice. Wayman, hey, yo, Ryan, what did we rub? Wayman. Yeah!
History Month edition of Candy Fresh.
The blackest edition.
I know that's right. And we want to make sure we send a big thank you to Dalton Outlaw for allowing us to be here, for hosting us here at Element Boston Fitness. Please give him a big round of applause. Because it almost didn't happen, but it did. I also want to give a big shout out to Parker Parker for snatching wigs out there on the red carpet. And I also want to give a shout out to Jaga for the creator of an entirely new language. I'm still back there. Just want to say thank you to him.
Yes, and we also want to send a major thank you out to Ron Brown for sharing his work with us, as well as PaviElle French for her awesome performance and interview as well. And of course, we could not end the show without saying thank you to DJ Fundraiser for holding down for us on the ones and twos all night. Much love and much appreciated. And of course, for the Wayman Steppers for coming through. Those young men
held
it down. Thank you to Wayman Church for sending their young men to provide us with that excellent showcase. We most definitely appreciate it.
Now make sure you follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and like our fan page. It's the Crown Lens Media Group.
That's right.
And last but not least, we got to give it up for the Candy Fresh audience. It's the best audience in the world.
Well, that is all the time that we have. We want to thank you all for tuning in to another episode of Candy Fresh. Happy Black History Month to all of you. Stay sweet, and as always, you're watching
Candy Fresh.
Yes!
It's that Candy Fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy Fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy Fresh gon' show up. Get your